network. E-health, i-health, digital health, mobile health, healthcare systems are getting more popular in the world. And my talk is one of the applications of the healthcare systems for rescue of the elderly and disabled person in particular. By the way, this is my homepage URL and self-introduction underneath. And you can reach me with this email address. So if you have the questions, I would be happy to respond to it after the session. Because the time is limited. Another 25 minutes, I have to finish my talk. Otherwise, you will not be able to have the lunch break for 1 hour. So this is the problems. I will skip. Motivation of research work is the following. The elderly person in Japan who age is more than 65 years old, quite incredible number. One third of the Japanese population is the elderly person. And the disabled person, we do have 3.7 million. It's approximately 1/29 of the Japanese population. It's a great number of the disabled person are there in Japan. And they used to live in the group home, GH. And such a group home is situated in the very dangerous area, not safe area, hazard areas and steepy areas. So if the disaster occurred, hit the group home, the people who are living in the group home have to evacuate from the disaster area, but the disabled person needs the help to evacuate. That's why I create such this systems. Dementia peoples walk away, used to walk away from their group home quite frequently, and more than 10,000 dementia people are missing a year, and most of the missing people are dead, unfortunately. If we have the location and the attitude sensor attached to the dementia people, then we can find the such a person and rescue the such a person. That's why I create such this systems using the wallet, the smartphone included in, and wear their glass. I call this Arise glass, which allows us to measure the body temperature, the number of the breath, and the heart rate. And in accordance with the medical doctor, the dementia people don't forget their wallet, and glass. That's why I use these two, glass and wallet. And in the wallet, I put the smartphone and the wireless battery charger does work for the smartphone battery life is longer than, and the grass they used to use were the grass. And grass, as I mentioned before, itself a sensor. Body temperature, the number of the breaths. And we have to measure the physical health condition, but also the psychological conditions. You know, vital sign means the body temperature, blood pressure, number of the breaths, heart rate, and consciousness. So psychological status has to be measured. And as I mentioned before, e-health, i-health, mobile health, digital health, healthcare systems are getting popular in the world. And by using such systems, I create the rescue systems. And the key things for this rescue system is the triage. Prioritize the victims first class to fifth class. The first class, we have to first priority of the victims have to evacuate immediately. And the second class, third class, fourth and fifth class, priority is getting down. This is the definition of the triage with the vital sign, the number of the breaths, heart rate, body temperature, blood pressure, consciousness. These vital signs have to gather with the sensor network and categorize, prioritize. The class zero means the dead person. And the class one, highest priority. Second one is the middle priority. And third one is the lowest priority. The problem on the vital sign monitoring is that blood pressure is not so easy to measure. And the rescue with the consideration of triage, we have to consider how to rescue dementia people. As I mentioned before, location, attitude, and vital sign, if we know, then we can rescue such a person. That's why we need the decision making. If the victims walking, then by using the accelerometer in the smartphone, we can measure the attitude. Walking, sitting, lay down, or stand up, such attitude can be monitored with the accelerometer. If yes, then injured by using the vital sign, gathered the sensor network. If yes, then no problem. If not, then categorize to class three, such and such. By using a decision-making process, we can determine the classes or priority of the victims. This is my proposed mobile health. Here I have the sensors attached to the body, and through the Bluetooth, we can transmit the gathered information, vital signs, through the internet and send to the data correction center. And all the decision making can be done in the data collection center and transmit the evacuation information or some volunteer who help the someone, some victims. Such a system I created. This is one of the examples of the GIS representation. Now the victims, wheelchair, and the volunteer rescue people. And then here I have the shelter, or hospital, or group homes. And another example of the GIS representation of the vital sign and location and attitude, status, walking. The red circle indicate the one of the victims walking on the street with the 1 kilometer per hour of the velocity, body temperature, blood pressure, heart rate, and so on and so forth. Here I have the schematic view of the ARISE graph sensor network. In the frame of the graph, the body temperature sensor and the heart rate sensor and the number of the steps can be measured with the smartphone, and the calorie consumption also calculated in the smartphone, and Bluetooth network capability and battery are included in the frame of the glass. And here I have the head mount display. Forget about this. Transparent. And the near infrared camera looking at the victim's eye. And here the two electrodes. One is for the EEG sensor. Brain wave can be monitored with the electrode. But EEG sensor used to be suffered from the noises. That's why I put the near infrared camera to take a photo of the human eyes. A variety of the body attached sensors for experiment, heart rate, or some others, GPS receiver, and a Wi-Fi beacon receiver in the smartphone. So if the victim's in the hospital, then GPS receiver doesn't work, but a Wi-Fi beacon can be used for the determination of the location. As I mentioned before, there are some problems on the body attached sensor. GPS receiver and the Wi-Fi beacon using both of the location sensor, then seamless location measurement can be done. And the measured data can be corrected with the some calibration data. And the blood pressure, as I mentioned before, cannot be implemented with the ARISE graph. So estimate the blood pressure using the other measured data. EEG sensor is affected by the noises. So a pupil center of the movement of the eye tells us the psychological status. That's why I put the camera on the glass. Body temperature sensor, we use to measure the body temperature at the armpit, but ARISE glass measure the body temperature at the ear. There are some discrepancies between both, so we can correct by using the calibrated data. EEG sensor, and by using instead of using the EEG sensor, I use the near infrared camera attached to the glass and then looking at the human eyes. and the pupil center location jumped when they feel the psychological stress, and the blinks are good indicator for psychological stress, and the pupil is getting large when the consciousness is lost. Such information can be collected. Now, I'm explaining the experiment. One set of the experiment consists of the 10 minutes walk, 10 minutes rest, three times, and one set in the morning, in the afternoon, and the evening, a day. And 5 days a week, Monday to Friday, and 4 weeks a month, and 3 months for each year. So I measured the 3 years data I got. Here I have the participants, 11 participants. One of the participant patients is a weak Alzheimer's disease people, lady. And here I have the table which shows the self-evaluation of the psychological and physical stress. A stands for the physical, and B stands for the psychological stress. And the location measurement, inside the building and outside the building, seamlessly, we can measure the location. Attitude sensor included in the smartphone, iPhone, EEG sensor data. By using the EEG sensor, we measure the alpha frequency component and the beta frequency component. The alpha frequency component tells us the relaxed mode, and if the human has the stress, then beta wave is dominant. Peak alpha frequency, relaxed mode. Peak alpha frequency, reading the complicated book. So we can distinguish between both. Here I have the example of the writing in English. This book, if the patient reading this book, then irritated. So a beta frequency component is dominant. And the blinking is a good indicator of the psychological stress. And peak alpha frequency and blink is corresponding. The psychological stress score in the horizontal axis, ranged from the 3 to 5, and the vertical axis shows the physical measured data. So there is no specific relation between both. And the psychological stress score in horizontal axis and the beta axis physical data, and there is no significant relation. And here I have the score for the patient. Number 8 is very sensitive. Number 5, not sensitive. So patient feels stress individually. And here I have the another interesting result. Ladies are stronger than gentlemen against the psychological and the physical stress. Number 2, female and male. Very stress of the male is larger than the female. The score difference of the age, there is no age dependency at all. And most of the patient feel the physical stress by walking. Horizontal axis, physical stress, and the number of the steps increasing in accordance with the physical stress. psychological stress, there is no relation between both. And the correlation matrix, if I take, then I can create the equation which allows us to estimate the blood pressure by using the body temperature, heart rate, and the number of the steps. Here I have the regressive equation. And then I conducted the simulation study with the simple road network, and it takes time without consideration of the triage, prioritize the victims. It takes time. So that in this case, without consideration of the triage, then two victims are dead after the simulation. And the right-hand side is our proposed rescue systems with consideration of the triage, prioritize these victims. The initial conditions are the same. By using a random number generator, I put the rescue person and the victims and all the victims can survive. And here the our district map, road network, and I conducted such this simulation study. This is the result of the simulation study. Vertical axis shows the 0 to 10 number of the victims. And here I have the only one dead victims. And in this case, the road network had the 50 links, and the number of the victims is 10, and the volunteer rescue people is 8. And here I have the relation between the panic level. When the disaster occurs, the victims get in the panic so that the panic mode can be changed by the victims by victims. Rescue times goes up, and percentage ratio of the block load. Sometimes disaster when due to a disaster, the road are blocked, and the victims' level of the disability. So disability are different by victims by victims. And here I have the conclusion. The vital sign can be monitored even in the every second. Body temperature, heart rate, and number of the breaths, and consciousness. And we can estimate blood pressure by using the monitored data of the blood, body temperature, heart rate, and number of steps. And the consciousness can be monitored with eye camera, not using the EEG sensor. Attitude can be monitored with the accelerometer in the smartphone, walking or lay down or stand up and sit down. Such attitude can be monitored with the smartphone, and the location can be monitored with the smartphone of the Wi-Fi beacon and GPS receiver included in the smartphone. And the triage can be done with the proposed system, rescue systems, and the rescue time can be reduced by 30%. It's very, very significant number. That's it. Thank you.